I need that alchemist for something I'm stewing up for you. If you're smart, you'll find him. So, you sticking around for grains of wisdom?
So when we get to the boat, we can either look for that special chisel now, or go exploring for a little while. I'm happy with whatever you want to do.
No earthly key nor physical force can get past the magic of that lock. Don't even look at it.
I've seen a lock like that before. Reminds me of something I've seen Kyo sketch. He liked to combine various symbols into runes all his own. This one, I believe, means peace, unity, mercy, other things too. I assume he did, but how do we get inside?
We have other concerns.
Edge, keep rowing towards the statues of the oarsmen, then thread past between them.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won. But the Vanir had proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses. And for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore. But a rather senseless waste of precious life. Wouldn't you agree, brother? Precisely. Enough was enough. And at last, Odin's most brilliant advisor became determined to find a more enlightened path. He set about to broker a peace between the gods. It took some convincing, but ultimately Odin was persuaded to marry his deadliest enemy, a certain Vanir goddess, legendary not only for her fertile beauty, but her genius at the very Vanir magic that Odin had long aspired to master.
Freya married Odin? What was in it for her?
It was a sacrifice to protect her people. A selfless act of love. Truly, she deserves better than she got. But of course, there's more to that story.
Boy, over here.
Language center. We should look for more like this. We're not getting in there without a key.
You gentlemen certainly know how to get around.
Why don't you tell me how all this began with Baldur?
He just knocked on our door.
Baldur of Asgard just knocked on your door?
Yeah, he just showed up and started a fight. He said he wanted to know something. He said, I know what you are.
Oh, well, we'll circle back to that later. What exactly did he want to know?
I was on it before, brother.
He said I already knew what he wanted. Perhaps he mistook me for another.
That's quite interesting.
You scare up that alchemist, what needed finding?
I can read what this says now, but it's a name. Air! Whoa! The name made it light up!
It's the name of one of the Valkyries. That's quite curious.
Look here.
Yes, sir. Another map. Great.
Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
Huh!
Could it be? The Eight Thrones.
Stop being coy, Ed. Do you know this place or not?
I'm Mimir, the smartest man alive. I know many things.
Well, whatever this place is, it looks important.
To who? There is little of value here.
Just make sure you watch each other's backs in the storeroom. Wouldn't want to lose my loyal customers.
I can't believe Odin and Freya were ever married.
Love and hate are more closely intertwined than you might imagine.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
I completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Piece of the language cipher. Good.
Ah, Fafnir. I always wondered what became of him.
Wait, Fafnir? Like, Fafnir's storeroom Fafnir?
The very one.
But Sindri said he was a dwarf.
He was. And now he's a dragon. Funny how life works, isn't it?
He's chained up.
Perhaps we should keep an eye out for binding shrines and free the poor bastard. Aye, lads?
Come on!
here?
Oh, he's no friend of mine.
His throat is a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why free him?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Even a greedy little dwarf come dragon. You wee little bugger. Well, the dragon hasn't done much for his personality.